My name is Ellie. I'm a curriculum developer at CodyDuck, and today I'm going to be showing you how to build an album finder using the Spotify API. If you're finding us from YouTube, no worries at all. You can go to the description where the link will be for the written project tutorial, which is build an album finder with Spotify API that's written by me. And for this project tutorial, you'll need HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. So it'll be great if you know those fundamentals. Additionally, if you also have some React background, that'll be really great as well, because that's what we'll be using. In terms of the version, it'll be React 18, and you'll be getting the repository already set up through a GitHub link. Let's go ahead and get started. I right now have pulled up the Spotify for Developers website, so you'll just click on See in Action, and you can sort of see exactly how the Spotify API works, but we'll need to get our keys for this. So what I'm going to do is log in using my account. So I'm already logged in, and I'm going to click on the dashboard. So it says I haven't created any apps yet, so I'm going to go ahead and create an app, and then just basically fill out this info with whatever I want. So I'll put Spotify Finder app like that, and then I'll add a description, so an app that finds albums. Through here, it'll ask you for a redirect URI, so for this I'm just going to put a localhost because it won't really leave our computer. And then I'm also going to click on the I understand and agree with Spotify's developer terms and click save. Okay, awesome. So now we have our app set up. It should be as easy as that. And then now, once you go ahead and click on settings up here, that'll show you your client ID and then also your client secret. So just keep those handy for now. And then we're going to go to VS Code and set up the rest of our app. All right, so let's get started with setting up our code. So in front of you is the CodyDuck API template that I created, and this will help set up your web app. So what we're going to do is click on code, and then click on that copy URL to clipboard button. And then now we're going to go ahead into VS Code and open up a terminal. I use control tilde. And now using git commands, we're going to clone the repository onto our computer. So that will be git clone, and then I'll paste in the repository. And now that I've cloned it, I'm going to go ahead and cd into the folder that is called CodyDuck API template. And I'm going to open up that folder. All right, so in here, once you open the source folder, you'll see that we have an app.js, and then the CSS files, and everything else you pretty much need to start a web app. So I'm going to open up a terminal and go ahead and check if we have Node installed. So that'll be Node-V. And so I do, and I have version 18.17. So for me, this is enough. If you happen to have an older version of Node installed, then you can go onto the Node website and install the latest version. Cool. And then now I'm going to just double check that everything in this folder works. So I'm going to do an npm install to download all of the dependencies. And then now I will do npm run dev. So that is the command to kind of start the web app. So I will command click on this link and then double check that, yeah, we have everything set up and the CodyDuck project template shows up. Cool. So now let's get started with kind of finagling with the code. And we're going to be using React Bootstrap to sort of load in already pre-made components, basically. So I'm going to open up VS Code, and I'm going to install the Bootstrap library. And you're welcome to look at React Bootstrap documentation as well. So that command is npm install React Bootstrap Bootstrap. So I'm going to enter that into our app. And so now that we have that set up, we can now set up our env file that it's going to hold our Spotify API keys. So this is back when we referenced that earlier. In the CodyDuck API template folder, make sure it's the outer one. I'm going to go ahead and create a .env file. When we go to VS Code again, you're going to basically have the v underscore client underscore ID and no string or anything. You're just going to put in kind of the group of numbers and letters. And then same goes for the v client underscore secret. So we'll be putting those in here. and then saving this file. I'm going to, right under the import statement, drop in this const client ID variable and also secret. And so these variables just reference the ENV file. Okay, cool. So now let's start having some stuff show up. I'm going to go ahead and import some of the components that we'll be getting from Bootstrap. So the first is form control, input control, container, and button. The first thing that we do want to build is the search bar. All right, so inside of the return statement, I'm going to remove these brackets and go ahead and paste in a container. So now in here, we're going to be ready for the search function and the set search function. So for now, I will erase these, and you'll see here we have a search bar ready. I brought these back just because we're going to start tackling now pretty soon the search function. Inside the app function, but above the return statement, we're going to go ahead and paste in these variables. And these are going to be our state variables for the search input and also the access token. And here I'm going to paste in the use effect hook, which is basically making a post request and then using our client ID and client secret to get that. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to paste in this asynchronous search function. This is using a get request, and this will be using our access token that we have generated, and it'll use that to then get the artist ID so that we can know who we're searching for. Okay, so I have pasted in now the updated form control code. So what we have in here is the onKey down has been updated so that once you press enter, the search function runs. And then the onChange means that setting the search input so that once you have typed in like an artist name, it saves that. And then the button also, of course, when you press the search button, that also runs the search function as well. Okay, and to double check just that everything works, I've added in some console logs in here inside the search function. So we'll get the search input and artist ID. So real quick, I'm going to do Wallows and search that. And then now we don't see anything show up. But if we go to our console, we'll see that we now have search input Wallows, and then artist ID is now return. And that belongs to Wallows. So we have successfully connected to the Spotify API and are getting results. So then another thing that I'm going to do is to get started on, we have the artist now, and then we also need to get the artist albums. So I'm going to create another state variable for albums, and then this is going to be an array instead of just strings. So now I'm going to paste in the get artist albums kind of logic here. Okay, so we have kind of finished up in terms of dealing with the Spotify API part, and now we're going to be doing kind of my favorite part personally, which is designing and UI layout. So as per the project tutorial, this is an example of what a card is going to look like in terms of when the albums show up when we query for a certain artist. So we have the image of the album, so the album cover, the name, the release date, and then link to the album on Spotify. There are a lot of other things that you can actually query for in terms of like information about an album. These are just kind of the ones that I chose. Feel free to go ahead and kind of look at Spotify API documentation if you'd like to customize this or even not include certain things at all. So we're going to go ahead and design this, and for this we're going to need cards and then also the row component from React Bootstrap. So I'm going to go ahead and head back over to the code here, and inside of where we had our previous imports, I'm going to add row and card. Okay, cool. And then now right here, right under inside container, but outside of input group, I'm going to paste in a container inside that has that is setting up a row basically. So we are just near the end, and so I'm going to paste in a bunch of code. It looks like a lot. All of this code is available if you check out the project tutorial. But basically, so we have a card that is going to hold our image, our title, text, and then also a button for the link, as we have shown earlier. Again, there's so many more. Definitely check it out. now we're gonna go ahead and save this, and theoretically our code should work. So I'm going to search up my favorite band of all time. We're gonna search it, and then boom, we have the images and the cards that show up here. So these are all the albums. They are beautiful. And now we can do someone more normal. Taylor Swift. So let's search up kind of what a lot of albums look like. Taylor Swift has a bunch of albums. So Tortured Poets Department, Midnight. So again, these are all kind of sectioned off by four. I'm also going to kind of show you it's mobile friendly. So we love to see that. Thank you, Bootstrap. And yeah, and that's kind of the finished product. Thank you all for following me along in this project tutorial. As mentioned before, written instructions and a more in-depth explanation of everything is available in written form on codedex.io/projects. So you're able to also not just see this one, but like 30 plus more of project tutorials that me and the team have put out. So thank you so much for joining me. And if this was helpful, please let us know. We would love to continue creating more in the future. See y'all.